Hi, I'm Dr. J.D. Armstrong. I'm an astronomer that works for the University of Hawaii Institute for Astronomy as an outreach specialist here on the island of Maui. Basically, that means I get to study the universe and share what I learn with my local community. In my last video, I showed a safe way to observe the color of the sun using a sheet of paper. If you haven't already watched that video, you might find it interesting, and so you can go and watch it now. If you'd rather, you can continue watching this video. This video should stand on its own. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to make a camera obscura. A camera obscura is also known as a pinhole camera, and it's basically a box with a small opening on one end. Light enters through the opening and forms an image on the back of the box on the other end. Before we start making the camera obscura, let me explain how it works. I have here a diagram that I hope will help me explain how a camera obscura works. On the left is a stick figure palm tree that represents the object that's going to be imaged by the camera obscura. In the middle, I have a line with a small gap that represents the light barrier, or the box, and the small opening used in the camera obscura. On the right, I have a white square that represents the screen on the back of the camera obscura. This is where the image of the object will show up. Two things that we should remember when we're talking about a camera obscura is, first, that light travels in straight lines. And second is that when an object like a palm tree is lit up by the sun, the light is scattered out in all directions. Not all of the light is scattered. If the light strikes something that's green, like the leaves of the palm tree, then only the green light gets scattered out. All of the rest of the light gets absorbed. Let's consider this first point on the palm tree. Some of the light that is scattered will go out in this direction. But the light going in this direction will strike the barrier and will be blocked by it. It won't make it to the screen. Some of the light goes in this direction, again being blocked by the barrier. Some of it goes in this direction, again it's going to be blocked by the barrier. Only the light that travels in this direction will make it through the small opening to the screen. That light will light up a small spot on the screen, and the spot of light will be green in color because the green light is what was scattered. Now we consider another point on the palm tree, let's say over here at this leaf. The only light from that leaf that makes it to the screen, again, has to pass through this small opening. And so the only place that the light makes it to is a small spot on the screen here. And again, it will make a lit up green spot on the screen. Now let's consider a couple of points from the trunk. The light from this part of the trunk that makes it to the screen only arrives here. All the other rays of light are blocked. Since the trunk is brown, the spot of light on the screen from this point on the trunk is going to be a brown spot. We can continue this for a few more spots. This spot on the trunk will make it through and light up this part of the screen. Light from this part of the trunk will make it through and light up this part of the screen. And we can continue considering all the points on the tree until we build up in our minds how the image of the tree forms. The tree forms a real inverted image. Inverted means it's upside down. Real means that we can see this image on the screen with our eyes. Okay, now that we've learned how a camera obscura works, let's go ahead and make one. Some of the things that you're going to need is you will need a box. You don't need one this big, but the larger the box, the larger the image will be. We actually had one program where we made camera obscura that were large enough that you could put them over your head. Then you'd have the hole on one side and you could look at the screen on the other and see the projection. Those worked pretty well. But this is plenty big. If you've got something the size of, say, a shoebox, that should be sufficient. You're also going to need a small piece of aluminum foil. You'll need some sharp object like an X-Acto knife or some scissors. Then you'll need some tape. I have quite a variety of tape here, probably three selections more than I need. You just need some tape. You don't have to be as obsessive as all this. You'll need a sheet of white paper. If you have some black construction paper, you could use that to line the inside of your camera obscura. That would help prevent a lot of the scattered light. And you will also need something like a toothpick or maybe a bamboo skewer, just something to make a poke a small hole in the aluminum foil. And you'll see what I mean in just a little bit. So I'm going to change the camera angle so that we can see, so you can see what I'm doing a little better. And let's go ahead and make this camera obscura. The first step in making the camera obscura is we want to make an opening on the box where we're going to cover with the tin foil, and that'll be where the light will come in. To do that, you need a sharp object like an X-Acto knife. Make sure to ask your parents' permission, maybe even get adult supervision. I asked my mom for permission to do this, and she said that that was okay. If I'd be careful. She told me I had to be careful. So I'm going to be careful here. And what we're going to do is we're just going to cut a small square. And I'm going to go a little off to the side. The idea is that I might put a tablet in here or something, see if I can get a picture of what's going on. So I'm going to put it off to the side. You might want to put it closer to the center. But I'm going to put it off to the side a little bit. And it doesn't have to be very big. This is probably bigger than I really need, but okay. So there we go. Just a little tiny square, just so I can make an opening very easily. The next thing we want to do is we want to put a small piece of aluminum foil covering this opening. Okay. So I'm going to tear off a little piece of aluminum foil. Okay. So something like this. And I don't need all of this, so I'm going to cut a little piece of aluminum foil. Just enough that I can easily cover the opening. The idea is that this will have a little pinhole in it and it'll make the opening. So I'm going to take some tape. I think I'll do the blue masking tape. And while you're doing this, remember, yours does not have to look just like mine. You've seen the theory of how it works, and so I encourage you to use some imagination and to make this work for you. You know, using the materials that you happen to have around your home. And just tape that on there. And tape the other side. Just like that. I'm going to tape the top and the bottom because I like kind of the symmetry. Oh, slid off the little support there is using the X-Acto knife box. And I'm going to do this. So there we go. Now right in the center of this, if I'm very careful, I can feel about where that is. Now I'm going to take a toothpick here. I'm going to take a toothpick and I'm just going to poke a little tiny hole in that. It's a very small hole. I would suggest starting with a small hole, and then if you need to, you can make it bigger. If you make the pinhole too big, then you're not really going to get an image of the sun. Instead, you'll get kind of a shadow or an anti-shadow maybe of the hole. Okay, so now I'm going to open up the box. And hopefully I'm going to see if I can't get this flap to stay down. Seems like it is. And I'm just going to tape it on the back here. That's why I need to tape it, otherwise it'll fall. Okay, the idea is that the light is going to come from the pinhole in through the camera obscura and project onto this white piece of paper. So we're using this white piece of paper sort of like a projector screen. In fact, just like a projector screen, right? And so I'm probably not going to get as neat a job on this as I did on the aluminum foil. Okay. And one thing nice about doing the aluminum foil is that if your hole is the wrong size and you end up going too large, you can just pull off the aluminum foil, put a new piece on there. If something happens to ruin that little opening, it's no big deal to change it. So I'm just going to finish taping this. So, then we can go ahead and close this up. And maybe don't need to tape the top as carefully as I've taped the rest of it, but I'm going to go ahead and run a piece of tape all along the top here. Remember, if your box is different than mine, then just try to think about how this works and what you're trying to do is you're trying to eliminate light coming in from all different directions. You're trying to make all the light come through this one little pinhole. Okay, so that's so far, but now I can't see into the box. So I'm going to come over here on the side and I'm going to cut a hole in the side. Depending on how big your box is, I guess I probably could cut a hole right here. What you want to think about when deciding where to put the viewing hole is that you don't want your head to be blocking the sun. You don't want your head to be blocking this pinhole when you're looking inside. Because if your head blocks the light coming in, well, it kind of defeats the purpose, right? So I'm going to try two things. I'm going to try putting one here. And then if I need it, I'll come back and I'll cut one in the side. So I'm just going to cut, maybe, I don't know, my eyes, okay, about this big maybe, I don't know. And so it doesn't need to be too big, it just needs to be big enough for you to peek through. It doesn't have to be round, it doesn't have to be perfect. I probably should have waited to tape up the box. Oh, I was fortunate enough, kind of came out. Okay, now let me just take a peek in here. Okay, so let's go ahead and take this outside and we can go ahead and try it out and see what we see. A little bit of cloud cover, it makes pretty easy for us to see how the camera obscura works. I've got the pinhole is a little larger than what I originally was using. You can see if we got it projecting on the tape there a little bit. You've got some cloud cover and you can clearly see the image of the cloud forming on that back screen. One thing I talked about in my last video was the color of the sun. In order to look at that with a camera obscura, I wanted to have a calibration source or a reference source. And so I added in this small white flashlight so that I was able to see the color of the sun compared to something that I know is white. Here's a picture of what that looked like. In my last video, I talked about the color of the sun, and I specifically mentioned three colors, red, green, and blue. There are other colors, but those three colors are significant.
They form the basis of our perception of color, and I'll tell you about that in my next video. I hope you've enjoyed watching this video about making a camera obscura, and if you have, please let us know by clicking on the like button below. Also, your friends might enjoy it as well, so please share it with them. Finally, if you were able to make a camera obscura, we would love to read about it, so please leave some comments for us. Thank you, and ahuiho.